Hello, I am Chris Menard. I've already covered Copilot in Word, Excel, OneNote, PowerPoint, Teams, but I haven't done a video on Copilot in Microsoft Forms. So let's go ahead and dive in here and let's see what Copilot can do in Forms. One real quick note before I even start this, there are two requirements for using Copilot in Forms. One, you must have a Microsoft 365 Copilot license. And the second item is the Microsoft 365 license required for this is business, education, or enterprise. Any other license, this isn't going to work. So I have Microsoft Forms running. I'm going to click on New Form. And there is Draft with Copilot, just like I see in Microsoft Word. I actually have some prompts here. Let's look at those first. That is pretty cool right there, including the HR one. But I want to make my own prompt. So here's my example. Let's say that I'm going to be teaching an Excel training class. And in that class, I'm covering the topics sorting, filtering, pivot tables, whatever else I'm covering. I would want to include that here when I type it. So you don't have to watch me type. I've already got this on my clipboard, so let me just paste it in here. There we are. Create a survey for Excel training. The training conducted covers sorting, filtering, and pivot tables. The instructor will be Chris Menard. Include questions about the effectiveness of the trainer. So let's go ahead and generate, and let's see what Copilot gives us. Copilot is done, and just like in Microsoft Word at the bottom, I can keep it. I can also come in here and ask for some small changes or fine-tune it, but let's scroll to the top and see how it looks. Excel training survey, it put in my name because I was teaching the class. I love question one. That's actually a question that I would use. So this is how I look at this. Do the questions I see here, would I keep them? And if the majority is probably yes, this is going to be a great feature. Question one, question two, I like. Question three is about the trainer. You could edit any of these questions, by the way, after you click on keep it. If you notice, there's a 5-star rating, but you could come in here with Microsoft Forms and change this, I believe, to thumbs up, and you can go anywhere from 5 to 10 stars. Great question there, I would keep. Would you recommend this training to others? That question works. I could also have just a yes, no in there. That would be good. Any future training? That's pretty cool that it asks about that. So now that I know that it's asking this question, question six, let's see if I can fine tune this. Include future training to include removing duplicates. Let's see if it does this. Sure did. It's still question number six, and they have removing duplicates. I probably could have added a few more items in here. That is great. And again, another 1 through 5 star. So yes, this is a really, really nice feature. I'm going to click on keep it just to show you this. So after I clicked on keep it, I told you could change the number of stars. Let's make sure I'm not lying to you. Trust me, I'm not. Stars, numbers, hearts, all these options here. Let's see what I can do here. Let's go 10. Perfect. I hope you enjoyed this video. My online training includes Copilot, Teams, Microsoft Excel, and OneNote. Also, if you enjoyed this video, feel free to subscribe to my channel and ring the bell. Have a great day. Thank you.